The table represents a linear or exponential function. We're asked to find the equation of the function. So the first step is to analyze the table to see if we have a linear function or an exponential function. If the function values have a pattern of repeated addition, we have a linear function. If the function values have a pattern of repeated multiplication, we have an exponential function. So looking at the table, notice how the inputs or x values increase by 5, and now let's look for a pattern in the function values. The function values go from negative 3 to negative 1, negative 1 to positive 1, and 1 to 3. Notice how the function values are increasing by 2, which means we have a pattern of repeated addition. Negative 3 plus 2 is equal to negative 1, negative 1 plus 2 equals 1, and 1 plus 2 equals 3. So now we know we have a linear function, and therefore the equation of the function is going to be in the form of f of x equals mx plus b, where m is equal to the slope, which equals the change in the output divided by the change in the input, or in this case, we'd have the change in f of x divided by the change in x, and b is equal to the vertical intercept, which is also called the initial or starting amount. So looking at the table of values, notice how in this first column, we have the ordered pair 0, comma, negative 3. So because we have the ordered pair 0, comma, negative 3, this is the vertical intercept, and therefore we know that b is equal to negative 3. So now we need to find the slope, which equals the change in the output divided by the change in the input. So looking at the table, if we recognize the function values or outputs increase by 2, each time the inputs or x values increase by 5, we can determine the slope is equal to 2/5. If we don't recognize this, what we can do is use two ordered pairs from the table and then calculate the change in the output divided by the change in the input. So let's also show this. So we can use any two ordered pairs from the table that we wish. Let's go ahead and use these first two. So using the ordered pair 0, comma, negative 3, and the ordered pair 5, comma, negative 1, we'll now calculate the slope, where again the slope is equal to the change in the output, or the change in the function value, divided by the change in the input, in this case the change in x. So the change in the output is going to be negative 1 minus negative 3, and the change in the input is equal to 5 minus 0. So again, we'd have the change in the output is negative 1 minus negative 3 divided by the quantity 5 minus 0. Sometimes you'll see this formula also as the quantity y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by the quantity x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Simplifying in the numerator, minus negative 3 becomes plus 3. Negative 1 plus 3 equals positive 2. The denominator is just 5, so this does verify our slope is 2/5. This is also telling us that the output or function value increases by 2 each time the input or x value increases by 5. So now we can write the equation of the linear function. The equation is f of x equals, well, m is equal to 2/5, so we have 2/5 x. B is equal to negative 3. Instead of writing plus negative 3, let's just write minus 3. So this is the equation of a linear function given by the table. Let's also verify our work graphically by graphing this line on the coordinate plane and making sure these four points are on the line. The line is graphed here in blue, and notice how all four points in the table are on this line. Also notice how if we were to move from this point to this point, we would have to go up 2 units and right 5 units, which is the reason why the slope is equal to 2/5. The function value or output increases by 2 each time the input or x value increases by 5. I hope you found this helpful.